In the previous video, we talked about all the ways in which the nervous system is physically structured into central and peripheral, sensory and motor, somatic and autonomic, and sympathetic and parasympathetic. And we also got into the basic functionalities of the different parts and divisions, like what parts of the body the somatic goes out to versus the autonomic. Well, here, we're going to dwell a bit more on how the nerve cells or neurons and all these parts work together to make a system that gives us such a vast range of abilities. Spectacularly complex, yet performing in a relatively, though not entirely orderly fashion that ultimately allows an animal to do the work that needs to be done in getting its genes into the next generation of animals. Yes. It does boil down to natural selection, shaping the evolution of the nervous system of animals, of which ours, the human nervous system, is the most complex and the most sophisticated in the animal world. The basic idea is incredibly simple. Sensory devices like the photoreceptors in your eyes, touch receptors in your skin, or chemical receptors on your tongue or in your olfactory bulb send nerve impulses via nerve cells to the central nervous system, where sensory nerve cells connect with other nerve cells within the central nervous system that connect with other nerve cells that connect with others in a way that processes and maybe stores the information. Meanwhile, your motor nervous system is activated by motor centers in the brain and spinal cord, and its neurons go out and tell the motor units to do whatever it is that they'll do. There are some places where the wiring between the sensory and motor is very short. The classic example here is a spinal reflex, in which the sensory impulse is received by a single spinal neuron that then just reaches over to the motor neurons that can then cause a muscular contraction. Here's your hand that touches a hot fajita plate, the one the waitress warned you not to touch, but you forgot. The sensory neuron from your hand carries that impulse the length of your arm and half your torso width to your spinal cord, where it triggers an interneuron. That's the term used for any neuron with both its receipt and delivery of nerve impulses entirely within the central nervous system. The interneuron sends its signal only a short distance within the spinal cord over to motor neurons that then will send a signal down to the muscles of your arm, causing it to pull back quickly. With this kind of simple wiring, the response can be very fast. In contrast, any kind of response more sophisticated than just pulling your hand away from a hot surface will likely require a bit more time. A complex pattern of nerve impulses have to get sent up to the brain and processed. It'll probably even be a different part of the brain that sends impulses down the spine to your somatic motor peripheral nerves. At the center of all this action is the nerve cell. And it should be no surprise to you that we'll be spending the next couple of lessons learning about how the neuron does its job of receiving nerve impulses and then sending nerve impulses down its axon to other cells.